Well, it is that time of year again when teachers start to look forward to all of the wonderful testing that they get to do in their classroom, right? Well, unfortunately, testing and doing assessments is just part of teacher life nowadays. However, I am not a big fan of most of the testing that we have available to us. Well, I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and I hope that you will stick around as we talk about what to use to measure math progress instead of using a math progress monitoring tool in our quest to build our math minds so that we can build the math minds of our students. Now, let me start off with why I think most progress monitoring tools are doing it wrong, basically. Like, why don't I like these tools? So my first one is a lot of the tools measure based upon the wrong scoring techniques. So here's a little example from a popular progress monitoring tool. I've blocked it out for anonymity purposes, but a lot of these, I guess, kind of look similar, that basically you are scoring based upon how many digits they get correct. So you're not even looking at the overall, did they get it right or wrong, but it's how many digits did they get correct, which I guess is a little bit better than just marking it incorrect or correct. But the problem is that when we get the results back as teachers, because typically as teachers, we are not giving the assessment, it's often given by somebody else and all we get back is the score, is that these scores don't really tell us much about the student thinking. So let's take a look at one of these problems in particular, the 83 minus 34. So let's say that some of the students, we get different answers, and somebody gave the answer of 51, somebody gave 59, somebody gave 48. And of course, there's the correct answer as well of 49. And a kid there would get 2 points according to the scoring system of this progress monitoring tool. But these results, these answers that kids are giving, don't really give us insight. All we know is that the first kid got 0 points, the second kid got 1 point, and the third kid also got 1 point. But it doesn't really tell us anything about why they got those points. What mathematical knowledge led them to that answer, and how do we use that information from the assessment to help us help them? How do we use that to help them become better? One of the main purposes of assessment is for us to use that assessment to inform our instruction. And way too many of the progress monitoring tools don't do that for us. All right, the other thing that I just don't love about most of the progress monitoring tools is that they're on one side or the other of the types of content that they are assessing. So the example that I had showed previously was fully focused on computation. It's just a sheet of computation, and we're looking at, are they able to add and subtract or multiply, divide? As you get into fractions, it's computation with fractions. It's just about computation. Now, the other side is assessments that try to focus on all the concepts of mathematics. So it'll have stuff, some computation tasks, it'll have some stuff on measurement, it'll have some geometry. So it covers everything. And the issue I have with that is that, especially for kids who are in need of intervention, the focus should not be on measurement and time and money and geometry. The research shows that kids in need of intervention need a strong focus in number. Now, the problem is that assessments, when we say number, they start to focus in on computation with number. But an understanding of numbers is not just computation. It's a whole lot about number sense and place value and some flexibility with numbers. And so we've got to use, if we want a true understanding of where kids are struggling, we have to look beyond just computation, and most of the assessments don't do that. So we do need to be focusing on number and number sense, but that is not just through computation. So what do I recommend instead of what's out there? Now, here's the problem. Even though you watch this video and I give you some information, you may be forced to use one of these types of assessments that are out there that I say are really bad because that's what's required of you. But I want to give you some information through this video that makes you be able to say, you know, in your heart of hearts, you probably know, like, I hate this. I don't love this assessment, but you don't quite know how to verbalize what's wrong. You just are like, I hate this. But you don't know how to really combat it. So hopefully through the video of the couple of things I already talked about, but also showing you other things that are out there, it'll give you some knowledge to talk about why it isn't good and some alternatives that you could maybe present to people. So here's some other things that I suggest. One of the first ones is one that I developed is about number sense. And it is not standards based, it's not norm referenced, all of that kind of stuff. It's based upon things that kids are lacking. So you can't like check off a standard, yep, they've got this. It is all around number sense concepts. And there's a link below this video to all of the resources I'm going to talk about in the video, but this one does link to my stuff. It's to the freebies page, and one of the freebies on my page is the number sense assessment. And that is looking at ideas that are not necessarily taught in your standards, but that kids need in order to perform the standards and do well with the content at their grade level. Now, the other thing I would encourage you is if your school is wanting to look at computation and specifically the facts, like do they know their facts, I would highly encourage you to move towards using the math running records, because they not only focus on did they get it right, but they look at analyzing strategies. Do students have flexibility? How are they trying to solve these problems? Not just did they get it right or did they get it wrong. So Dr. Nikki is the go-to person on math running records. And I highly suggest hers because, number one, they're free. You can get the book, but she has them all posted, just the general running records on her site. Don't pay for some on Teachers Pay Teachers. Go directly to Dr. Nikki because she has based them upon research. They are very specific tasks that you give to the students to be able to dig out the strategies that kids are using. So if you need computational stuff, look at Dr. Nikki's math running records. And again, the link is below here. The third thing I would recommend instead of what's commonly used are all the assessments from New Zealand. You guys, I'm gonna link to their site. It can take you in some magical places. New Zealand has some amazing resources, and two of them are the ICAN and the GLOSS assessments. Now, Graham Fletcher did a session about these during the virtual math summit, and that's if you attended that you saw the whole thing. But I'm also going to link a quick little video. It's like 2 minutes that Graham does talking about the power of using an in-depth assessment, basically, because ICAN and GLOSS are, they take longer to give, but they're more in-depth. Here's the fact, guys. If you want something quick and easy, you can get quick and easy assessment, but the information you gain from it will be teeny tiny. If you want a wealth of information about your students' understanding, then you have to have an assessment that goes a little bit more in depth. And you personally need to give it because there's so much that you can glean by giving the assessment yourself. And the video I'm going to link to down below of Graham Fletcher talking about it just really talks about why that is so important and how you're giving up time to do an assessment, but it will allow you more time to focus on the things that are really important for your students. So I want you to watch that short little video of Graham's as well. So again, I want you to really look at the assessments you're giving at the beginning of school year, and is it giving you information that really can inform your instruction? And if it's not, then I would encourage you to look at those three alternatives that I'll link below this video. So I hope that this has given you some information about progress monitoring with your students and has helped you build your math mind so you can go out there and build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.